Humanity is prepared to begin a new era of interplanetary travel to Mars, our solar system, and beyond as nuclear power-related technologies promise to make such missions faster, more effective, and more economical. According to Elon Musk's most recent scientific advancements, we could finally be approaching the era of nuclear-powered space flight. NASA intends to use it for a human moon mission if all goes according to plan. According to the plans of the Pentagon, military equipment can be delivered worldwide within minutes. Astronomers, satellite companies, and potential space tourists are all interested in it, since it has the potential to dramatically reduce the cost of going to space. It is what Elon Musk refers to as a space technology holy grail. What is this desired piece of space technology? How does it work and what benefits can we expect from it? Humans have been captivated by the stars above us in many different ways since the beginning of civilization. Still, there is an extreme interest in the astrophysics of the universe beyond our solar system. This is mainly due to the numerous new scientific research carried out worldwide by space organizations. Suppose we wish to launch autonomous probes to the closest stars during a human lifetime. In that case, we need to develop new propulsion technologies enabling substantially greater speeds than now. Nuclear fusion is one of the most promising possibilities, although it has yet to produce commercially practical results. The lack of suitable technology is the main barrier to interstellar travel. The main problem with going there is that the stars are so far away. The stars closest to us, Proxima Centauri, is 4.3 light years away. This translates to 269,000 astronomical units AU, where 1 AU corresponds to the typical distance between the Earth and the Sun, or roughly 150,000 kilometers. Pluto is the most distant dwarf planet in our solar system, orbiting the Sun on average at a distance of around 40 AU, while the Sun is more than 7,000 times further away than Pluto. How long would the probe take to reach the Proxima in that case? The Voyager 1 probe, launched in 1977 to study Jupiter and Saturn, was the fastest human-built spacecraft. It left the solar system in 2012 and is now traveling at 17 kilometers per second, or 3.6 AU per year. From a human perspective, it would take approximately 74,000 years for Voyager 1 to reach Proxima if it were pointing in that direction. That is not a very beneficial time scale for a researcher to wait for their results. The utility of a space probe is determined by its ability to send back data on a timescale appropriate to humans, such as decades or even centuries. To be clear, we're talking about travel times that are 1,000 times faster than what Voyager 1 would take to reach Proxima Centauri. Because time equals distance divided by speed, we must devise methods for accelerating probes three orders of magnitude faster than is currently possible. Is that possible? It would be much easier to fly if we use fusion power. Researchers are attempting to develop methods to capture the massive amount of energy released during fusion events and use it to power a propulsion system. A fusion-powered spaceship could shorten the time it takes to reach Mars, thus accelerating the timeline for a human-crewed Mars mission. This type of spacecraft could mitigate the harmful effects of radiation and weightlessness. The development of a fusion-powered spacecraft would be comparable to the development of an Earth-based vehicle with twice the top speed of any car and a fuel economy of 7,000 miles per gallon. In rocket science, the specific impulse of a rocket engine is used to calculate its fuel economy. The specific impulse is the thrust unit per propellant unit spent over time. The ability of conventional chemical rocket engines to generate high specific impulses is limited. A typical chemical rocket engine has a specific impulse of approximately 450 seconds, which means it can cause 1 pound of thrust from 1 pound of fuel in 450 seconds. In contrast, a fusion rocket has a specific impulse of 130,000 seconds. Furthermore, hydrogen will be used as a fuel in fusion-powered rocket, allowing them to refuel while traveling through space. To refuel a spacecraft, we'll need to dive into the planet's atmosphere and suck in some hydrogen. Compared to chemical rockets, which rapidly deplete their fuel, fusion-powered rockets could provide longer thrust. Fusion propulsion is expected to enable rapid travel throughout our solar system, potentially allowing one-way trips from Earth to Jupiter in as little as 2 years. it now appears that the era of nuclear-powered space travel is finally upon us. SpaceX has been developing the most powerful rocket ever built, a massive stainless steel rocket. Combined with this booster stage, it stands 400 feet taller than the Statue of Liberty, and its pedestal will be completely reusable, unlike any previous orbital rocket. SpaceX, Elon Musk's private spaceflight company, was founded to make life on other planets possible in a catastrophic event, such as a massive asteroid strike. He claims that humans may be relocated to planets such as Mars to maintain civilization. In 2016, Elon Musk said, "History is going to bifurcate along two directions. One path is to stay on Earth forever, and there will be some eventual extinction event. The alternative is to become a space-faring civilization and a multi-planet species, which I hope you would agree is the right way to go." Elon Musk has made no secret of his desire to establish communities on Mars. He believes that large populations are required for towns to become self-sufficient. To make this vision a reality, we need a capable vehicle to handle the journey where Elon Musk's powerful Starship comes in. The system is designed to be entirely and instantly reusable. The term fully reusable refers to the fact that the main hardware components are returned to the ground for reuse rather than being burned or dumped in the ocean, as with some other launch systems. After returning from space, the Starship, like an airplane, can be quickly refueled with fuel and ready to launch again. As a result, the overall cost of the business is reduced. Since 2010, SpaceX has used the Falcon 9, which has grown to be one of the most important launches for international space flight. The Starship, on the other hand, is the next generation. What's the purpose of the Starship? NASA's Atmos program, which aims to establish a long-term human presence on the moon, will rely heavily on Starship technology. In April 2021, the U.S. Space Agency awarded SpaceX a $2.89 billion contract to transform Starship into a lander capable of transporting astronauts to the lunar surface. The heat shield and flaps required for a return trip to Earth would not be present in the version designed for Artemis flights within this decade. Instead, after its initial launch from Earth, the Starship's human landing system would remain in space, eventually being used for several excursions between lunar orbit and the moon surface. Elon Musk claims that the Starship may one day carry travelers to places within the more incredible solar system, such as gas giants like Jupiter, although this is still a long-term objective. Contrary to many of NASA's advanced propulsion concepts, which won't be realized for decades, the foundation for fusion propulsion is now being created. NASA received new research funding in 2018 and 2019 to resume NTP research with a test flight scheduled for 2024. Nuclear Thermal Propulsion Systems, or NTP systems, have been around for a while. Still, they have the potential to shorten travel times and carry more payloads than today's best chemical rockets, which are currently the most powerful. Elon Musk stated in a tweet last summer that a nuclear thermal rocket for fast transit around the solar system would be a great area of research for NASA, seemingly implying that NASA should focus on NTP development. At the same time, private companies advance with more sophisticated chemical rocket technologies. NTP systems pump liquid fuel, often hydrogen, through a reactor core. Uranium atoms split apart within the core during fission, creating heat. During this physical process, the fuel is heated, converting it into a gas that is expanded via a nozzle to produce thrust. NTP rockets are more energy dense than conventional rockets and twice as efficient as chemical rockets. In contrast to NTP systems, which use chemical hydrogen rockets that produce water vapor as a byproduct, which is much heavier, lighter gases can accelerate more readily than heavier ones. As a result, the NTP rocket may travel further while using less fuel, increasing efficiency. When other technologies are ready, a fusion-powered spacecraft might also carry people to Mars. In the middle of the 21st century, seeing Mars and the stars might be as commonplace as visiting the International Space Station is right now. It could be as easy as seeing our neighbors in the future. That is our video for today. We hope you like it. What are your thoughts on using nuclear fusion on a future spaceship? Share all of your thoughts with us in the comments section below. Well, that's all for now. This is Big Tech Media. See you again tomorrow. keep in mind to like, share, and subscribe.